Bus interfacing deals with how an input-output device connects to the bus. So in this picture of the computer with the various I/O devices, we are focused on how the various devices as well as the processor and memory interface with the bus, that is these red circles. Bus interfacing uses the notion of tri-stating, where there are three states. We are familiar with the first two states, 0 and 1, 0 usually represented by low voltage and 1 represented by high voltage. And we have a third state which is represented with Z, and this denotes a disconnected or high impedance state. So in this disconnected state, it is as if the I/O device is disconnected from the bus. Here is how we represent it diagrammatically. Here is the device and this is the bus, or we could have the other way around, where here is the bus and this is the device. In either case, we have this logic where we have an enable line represented as E. If E is 1, Y takes on the value of X, otherwise Y is disconnected from X. Here is a diagram representing how tri-stating works. I have taken an example where we have a 2-bit bus. These are the two bus lines. We have a device D which can write or read these bits. These I have denoted as W1 R1 and W2 R2 for the two bits. We have here an enable line corresponding to reading of data from the bus, that is E. And I have an enable line corresponding to writing data onto the bus. This is denoted as S. Likewise, I have another device D prime with R1 prime, W1 prime, R2 prime, W2 prime, as well as these enable lines marked as E prime and F prime. Now, in order to support transfer of data from D to D prime, what do you think should be the values of the various enable lines? Well, we should have F equal to 1 corresponding to D writing and E equal to 0. Likewise, we should have E prime equal to 1 corresponding to D prime reading and F prime 0. Likewise, we can use the pattern E equal to 1, F equal to 0, E prime equal to 0, F prime equal to 1 to have a situation where D prime is giving some data to D. The important thing is that we can have a situation where device D decides to disconnect itself from the bus by setting both E and F to be 0. In this state, it is known to be tri-stated. Device D is known to be tri-stated, or in other words, it is disconnected from the bus. There is a high impedance between device D and the bus. This state is useful, for example, when device D is not at all involved in any bus transaction, and let's say device D prime is communicating with a third device not shown in this diagram. In this diagram, what do you think will happen if we set both F and F prime to 1? If we set both F and F prime to 1, it is going to be a case of bus protocol error. This situation is never supposed to happen. And if this happens, you could have bad things not only in terms of program failing, but also in terms of the computer itself getting spoiled, or worse, a fire happening. Now, why do we have this tri-stating? As suggested earlier, if we have tri-stating where devices logically and electrically are disconnected from the bus, then we can potentially support a large fanout. That is, we can support a situation where there are large number of devices connected to the bus. Because most of the devices are going to be tri-stated anyway. What do you think will happen without tri-stating? Without tri-stating, we can have either large current flow or low voltage, which leads to bit errors. And large current flow can cause bad things, including system heat up and fire. Another advantage of tri-stating, as indicated in the previous diagram, is that a device can use the same set of bus lines for input as well as output. That is, whenever needed. Note that not all devices may need to write to the bus lines. depending on the situation. For example, memory need not write to the address lines at all.